Hey guys, welcome back. It's Missy, and today we're going to be talking about a topic that pops up a lot, especially during the holidays, especially during this crisis time, and that's thoughts about missing the narcissist. I'm really sorry about the background noise. I guess they're doing some sort of construction. It sounds like I live at a McDonald's, but I don't. It's just they're doing construction, so please try to ignore it. I guess me and the city forgot to exchange our work schedules, but it's fine. I'll take one for the team. So is it normal to miss the narcissist? Simple answer is yes. Thanks for coming to my TED Talk. Can you imagine my videos are that short? Nope, sorry. Your girl talks and talks. But seriously, when you get feelings that you miss the narcissist, some thoughts that will pop up are, am I crazy? Is there something wrong with me? Was the narcissist even really that bad if I'm missing them? Or you'll think, like, were they even a narcissist? And you will start to gaslight yourself in your own memory and think back to, like, remembering, like, if it really was that bad, because you're having cognitive dissonance where you're missing them and you don't understand why, and you're trying to make it make sense. So you think that you want to see them or you miss them. But it's actually pretty common to miss the narcissist. But let's go into some of the reasons why you feel like you miss them. The first reason why you may miss them is because you feel like you need them. Over the years that you've been around them, they always ingrained it in your brain that you needed them. They would do this by outright saying that no one would care for you like they do, or they would do it subliminally, subliminally, where they would say things to instill distrust in yourself. And they instill this distrust by making you question your own reality. If you don't trust yourself or your reality, you will feel like you need your abuser to tell you how to live. So now when you do things, you feel like you can't do it without them. You feel like you need their help or their guidance, or you'll have their voice in your head reminding you that you can't do these things or you needed them. So if you feel like you need someone, you're going to miss them. You're gonna long for them. You're gonna feel like you need them. It's a basic need. You feel like you need them as much as you need food, water, or shelter. So you feel like you can't survive without them. You may fear making decisions or doing basic things without them. Another reason why you may miss the narcissist is because of trauma bonding. Trauma bonding starts usually with a parent-child relationship, and it is attachment bond created through repeated abuse and love bombing. So it is a cycle where there is abuse followed by inconsistent reward. This is called intermediate reward. And what happens is every time you do a desired behavior, you are then inconsistently rewarded. So sometimes you're rewarded, sometimes you're not. For instance, let's say you make your mom breakfast. And then she's so happy, she's so loving towards you, she's very appreciative. The next day you do the same thing, you make her breakfast, but this time she slaps you and she yells at you and she's mad at you. Even though you had a negative experience, you still will crave that positive reinforcement that you got the day before. You want to gain that feeling of approval and love, so you will try again. This cycle of abuse and love bombing creates an emotional attachment bond. This then becomes a learned behavior and it becomes addicting. You crave that next release of dopamine and serotonin. You crave that high. So because this happens with trauma bonding, you as the victim don't realize that it's abuse. And then you associate abuse with love, as you had to please your abuser, you've had to do whatever it takes to receive that love from them. And since it's a learned behavior, it's really hard to stop. It's something that you're used to. It's been ingrained in your brain. And it can feel like a blanket's being ripped right off of you. You feel like you need them, and you feel that your love and bond will be taken away if you leave them. You'll never receive that love. It is an addiction similar to drugs, which makes sense because literally the chemicals in your brain are the same chemicals that go off when you're addicted to drugs. So since you are made to feel unworthy, undeserving, like you don't matter and helpless, you then take this with you into your relationships and you form trauma bonds with other narcissists. And then you associate the abuse with love and miss them. Which goes to the next point where you miss the high after the low. When you're around a narcissist, there's constant highs and lows. There's devaluing, gaslighting, tension building, inconsistency, explosions, love bombing. It's just up and down constantly. So you will notice that yourself craving them, because when you feel so low and then you get that release of dopamine, serotonin, oxytocin, it feels so good. It feels so much better when you are in pain, and then after you feel that release, that good feeling, and you can become very addicted to it. So that's what happens, is you become very addicted to those feelings, to that release of not knowing, like, oh, you know, are they gonna be happy today? Am I gonna get that love today? You know, what's going to happen? And it's up, you're constantly on a roller coaster, and it can be hard to get off of. This is the same thing that happens with playing the lotto or playing slot machines. Even though there's a high risk of you losing, you still become addicted to that high of not knowing when you will win and not knowing when it will happen. So you become addicted to that inconsistent reward because you never know when you're gonna get that reward. Another reason why is because you spend a lot of time on them. So when you're spending a lot of time on someone, what do you do with the time after they're gone? You spend a lot of time thinking about them, thinking about what they needed, thinking about trying to make their day, thinking about how they'll feel or react to things. And you put a lot of work into the relationship and into them. So afterwards, you may be not sure what to do with your time anymore. And because you have extra time, there's that saying, idle hands make the devil's work. So you have all that extra time. You're like, what do I do with my hands? Like, what do I do with this? You get urges to reach out to them. And so you will think you miss them because you have the extra time. Another reason why you may miss them is because you remember the good times. That's very common that happens after some period of time. We completely forget about the negative things and we remember mainly the positive things. That's why exes will go back to their exes. This is a good sign if you are someone that where you like someone and you messed up, they forgot about that weird thing you did. So that's the positive in that area. But when it comes to narcissists, like, you forget the bad times or the negative things they did, because over time you remember those positive times. You remember the time that you guys had a really fun, exciting time. You remember those times where they seemed like they were kind of normal and you could talk to them about things. And you completely forget about the negative times, how they maybe made you feel a couple days later, how maybe they threw it in your face after you told them something. So you'll completely forget about those negative moments. And that is kind of how it works with the narcissist. That's, you wouldn't be around someone if they were 100% awful. That's where the love bombing comes in. You remember those times where they love bomb you. You remember those times where they gave you all these gifts, or you remember the times when they actually gave you that hug that you've been wanting. That is when the gaslighting starts. That is when you start questioning your own reality. You question if it was really that bad. Are they really a narcissist if they would have done these things? The answer is yes. That is the cycle of a narcissist. You get stuck on the fantasy of what it could have been. You get stuck in the fantasy that they sold you. So it hurts to think about it because you remember those good times and you get lost in the potential of who they could have been. Which goes to the next point, which is, you are stuck on their false promises. So you get stuck on the person who they could have been, because I showed you a little bit aside of that. You were constantly fed lies of what it could be, and they fed you this fantasy constantly. You get stuck on the false promises and hope that maybe if you go back, they actually will change. Maybe if you go back, maybe it will be different. You know, you think people change, you've changed, maybe it will be different. So you remember all those false promises and you remember that they said they would do this or this would happen. But the thing is, those are all false promises. And those are all lies they told you to keep you where they want you. There's a very low chance that it would ever really happen. You've seen yourself, like, if they really were gonna do what they say, they would have been done it by now. So when you are having these thoughts that you miss the narcissist, just know you don't. One thing you could do to help yourself is write down in a journal, like when you're getting that feeling, oh, I miss them. Go write in a journal some of the negative things they have done to you, or the negative things they've said, or the negative things you remember. Remember the things you felt. Remember how negative they made you feel. that will immediately bring you back to that place and remember, like, oh yeah, no, we don't want to go there again. That way, it will bring that balance of remembering, yeah, maybe there was that good time, but the negative outweighed the good by a landslide. And you think, oh yeah, I remember why I left. When you are gaslighting yourself and ask yourself things like, am I crazy? Recognize that and recorrect yourself and say, no, I remember exactly how it happened and I am not crazy. Don't reaffirm the narcissist voice in your head. There is a new, self-assured, confident voice, and it's yours. Another thing you can do when you do gaslight yourself, aside from journaling, you think, was it really that bad, aside from listing the negative, you can remember the positives of you getting out of the relationship. You get to focus on yourself. You don't have to worry about somebody else. You can really truly find yourself and be yourself. You can be around people. You don't have to be controlled anymore. This is the time where you can focus on yourself and you don't need that person. You need you. So it's 100% normal, but you don't miss them. Because if you really went back, you would immediately regret it as you got sucked back into that cycle and you would be re-traumatized all over again. One of the main reasons why I wanted to make this video is because when I first started learning about narcissism, I would look things up on the internet and I would see a lot of people felt a lot of anger and hatred toward their narcissist. And I didn't feel that same hatred. I felt more like pity for my narcissist. I felt bad that they weren't able to understand what they were doing. I thought that they were this hurt child, and I would miss sometimes when they were normal, or like when I would make them laugh, like that made me feel good when I would make them laugh. And so I would question my reality and be like, well, are they really narcissistic if I'm feeling this way? It's like, I can't relate to these people. I don't have that same hatred and anger. And I mean, yeah, of course, like I had anger, but I would have these feelings of missing them. And so I would question it, and then I would remember the negative times I felt and how horrible it was. And I wanted to make this video to show, like, these are all normal. It's okay for you to hate and resent your narcissist, and it's okay for you to miss them. Those are all normal feelings. Every single person feels differently towards their narcissist. These are all normal. But the one thing that's in common is you knew you needed to get away. And you feel a lot better with them not in your life. So what do you guys think? Leave it all in the comments below, and please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and share with someone that you think may need it. Until next time, thanks for watching. Bye, guys. That's loud as hell. I can't compete with that. I really hope that's not that loud. Was it really that bad? And, you know, every single time I answered that question, I said yes. They told me terrible things. They made me feel terrible about myself. They made me question my reality constantly.